Nobody likes fruit flies, but they could hold the secret to the best beers you've never tasted. Stick around and I'll tell you why you may want to think twice before you go killing their buzz. Hey everyone, Matt here. Fruit flies are filthy, filthy creatures. They're always getting their larvae all up in your fruits and fermented beverages, but they're just slaves to their nature. When fruit flies sense something fruit smelly, they know food is nearby. Some of these compounds are ethyl acetate, isoamyl acetate, and ethyl phenyl acetate. Brewer's yeast, the kind used to make beer, has evolved to produce those same compounds. These compounds are essential for beer's delicious flavors, but scientists don't know what biological purpose they serve. That's a problem that's bugged Kevin Verstreppen, a genetics researcher at the University of Leuven and the Flanders Institute for Biotechnology in Belgium. Why would yeast cells go out of their way to make chemicals that could turn them into fly food? Verstreppen posed this question to a couple biologist friends, over beers of course, and the group decided to find out. The team brewed up a couple yeast cultures, one a wild lineage and the other a mutant strain missing the gene that helps produce acetate esters. Fruit flies, they found, were way more attracted to wild, smelly yeast. But researchers also noticed that as the flies fed, some yeast cells got stuck to the insects and hitched a ride. The flies picked up 4 normal wild cells for every one of the mutant strain. So it looks like the yeast are luring the flies with their aroma compounds in order to hitch a ride to colonize elsewhere. Sure, some of the yeast get eaten along the way, but they're usually so numerous they can afford this sacrifice so long as some cells can survive and start new colonies. Since making this discovery, the group has started looking at fruit flies in the wild and found that a typical specimen carries hundreds of yeast cells. Some flies carry yeast species that aren't even known to brewers yet. What does this mean? There could be tons of untapped beer flavors flying around. So the next time fruit flies are crowding your Hefeweizen, consider 1, why are you drinking a Hefeweizen, bro? And 2, give them a shoo-shoo instead of taking them to Slap City. And then raise a glass to yourself for protecting life and beer diversity. That's all for this Speaking of Chemistry. Don't forget to drink responsibly, leave a thoughtful comment, and subscribe and share. Cheers.